Welcome to an example on how to solve a system of nonlinear equations. We want to find all of the solutions to the system x squared minus 5y equals 6 and x squared plus y equals 18. We'll first solve this algebraically by using the elimination or substitution method, and then we'll check our solutions graphically. Again, we have the option of solving this using substitution or elimination. I'm going to go ahead and solve this example using substitution. In the next example, we'll use elimination or the addition method. So looking at this first equation here, notice if we solved it for x squared, we could perform a substitution for x squared in the second equation. So looking at this first equation, if we were to add 5y to both sides of this equation, we would have x squared equals 6 plus 5y. And since x squared is equal to 6 plus 5y, we can substitute 6 plus 5y for x squared in the second equation, which will give us an equation that just contains y, and then we can solve for y and perform back substitution to find the values of x. So performing this substitution, we would have 6 plus 5y plus y equals 18. Combining like terms on the left side of the equation, 5y plus y, or 5y plus 1y, would be 6y. So we have 6 plus 6y equals 18. And now to solve for x, we'll subtract 6 on both sides of the equation. So this will give us 6y equals 18 minus 6 is 12. Divide both sides by 6. And we know that y must equal positive 2. But each solution consists of an x value and a y value. So now we'll perform back substitution to find the corresponding values of x. Let's go ahead and use this form of the first equation that's already solved for x squared. So using x squared equals 6 plus 5y, we'll substitute 2 for y and then solve for x. So if y equals 2, that means x squared equals 6 plus 5 times 2. Well, 5 times 2 is 10, so we have x squared equals 16. We should recognize here we'll have two solutions for x, both a positive and negative value. And since we have x squared, to undo the squaring, we'll square root both sides of the equation, and we'll include a plus or minus sign on the right to make sure we obtain both solutions. And since the square root of 16 is equal to 4, x is equal to positive or negative 4, or plus or minus 4. So when y equals 2, x can be either positive 4 or negative 4. So we have two solutions. We'll go ahead and list them as ordered pairs. When x is positive 4, y is positive 2. Or when x is negative 4, y is also positive 2. Remember, when giving the solution as an ordered pair, the first coordinate is always the x coordinate, and the second coordinate is always the y coordinate. Let's go ahead and check this graphically by graphing both of the original equations on the coordinate plane, and these two points should be where the two graphs intersect. Notice how we have two points of intersection, one point here and one point here. The point in the first quadrant has an x coordinate of positive 4 and a y coordinate of positive 2, and the point in the second quadrant has an x coordinate of negative 4 and a y-coordinate of positive 2. So these two points of intersection verify our solution is correct. I hope you found this explanation helpful.